Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome to something new today. Yep, I picked up a copy of Madden 25 for the Xbox One. Yep, I'm playing on the Xbox One, and I felt it was time to transfer over and upgrade my Ultimate Team to the next generation. So that is where I played most of my Ultimate Team before, was on the Xbox 360. Now I'm transporting my team to the Xbox One to play in the next generation here of Mutt. So here we go. You are forced to go through the intro once again here to get to the point where you can transfer your team. So it's a little silly. You kind of got to go through not only the intro, but getting your starter pack and getting situated there all the way to the point where you would play an offline game, a offline challenge. And then when you back out of that, you can then transfer your team. So if you haven't gone through this process, maybe you'll learn something from this. Just pick a captain, any captain. I go all the way to the end and pick JJ Watt. It's not really going to matter too much other than my uniform set. So pick a uniform set you're happy with. And then you get your starter pack. So here we go. Standard starter pack. Just going to flip through it here, even though it doesn't really matter. Well, I guess it does matter in the fact that I think we do get to keep these cards also. I'm pretty sure that we keep these cards as well as what transfers over. So, you know, if there's anything valuable to you at all as far as uniform sets or, you know, coaches or whatever you might get in this, so be it. So there you go. There is the starter deck of cards, and I've got new awards earned. That's from the Gridiron Club. You can see I'm on the Xbox One, so you got the new achievement system showing up there on screen. They gave me an Adrian Peterson and Joe Montana 80 overall, both of them, as kind of a starter gift. Welcome to Madden NFL 25 bonus gift there on the AP. So there you go. So you go in to the solo challenges, and right here you do finally get the chance to transfer. So you hit right trigger, whatever it was there, right button, and you follow the prompts on screen. You go ahead and transfer. In my case, I'm transferring 209 cards in all, so they will come on over. And there we go. So we go to best team, and we go from a 68 overall, and the best lineup will bring us to an 86. So there we go. There are my cards from the last generation Xbox 360. Of course, when you choose best lineup, sometimes they keep your lineup a little thin. If you like keeping backups in there on the active team, then I suggest you go check that out, because usually they just bring the bare minimum for your lineup, and sometimes I like to carry a few more running backs or skill position guys, or, you know, whatever it may be, guys that tend to get injured or that you want to swap out different lineups and stuff like that. So go ahead and do that. But yeah, taking a look here, this is the team that I left off with in the Xbox 360 series and version here. I did a little bargain shopping there for playoff and fantasy type cards that were selling fairly cheap at the time. You see I've now got 17,500 coins to work with here on the brand new system as well. So we will be doing some more bargain shopping in this episode. So even though this is episode one of my next generation Xbox One Ultimate Team, you can kind of consider this a continuation of the Xbox 360 series. And I will link the last video from that series in the description here if you want to follow along where I got this team and where I got these cards to this point. So there we've kind of looked through what the starting lineup looks like. Now it's time to open some loyalty packs, four and all. I'm not expecting a lot in here, mostly contracts that I can use for players I already have. And you're going to find guys that are basically, I don't know, silver level, you know, whatever. I guess that Chris Cook is considered a gold, but whatever. They're low golds, high silvers, and contracts. So we'll open all four of these. Now we're down to three. See a Tracy Porter in there. Not going to get excited about the cards so much. Henry Hynoski, pretty decent fullback, 79 overall. Still don't think he would be a starter for me, though. So here we go, two left, starting with Nate Garner there. More contracts. Mike Adams. Yeah, you get the drill. Brandon Gibson. Okay, so one more of these loyalty packs that aren't really going to help me a whole lot. outside of the contracts. We'll always take contracts for our guys who are rated higher that are going to stick around in the lineup. So once again, yep, pretty much worth the contracts and not a whole lot else. So there we go. We will now do some bargain shopping. I see Michael Bennett here, 93 overall, divisional fantasy card here. Going to snag him for cheap. Going to do the same with the Ray Melaluga here at the middle linebacker, because that's a position that will help me. Some of these were low contract, but that's okay. I'm going to add contracts to them. Kevin Burnett, 87 overall, right outside linebacker. That is currently better than what I'm starting. Let's snag him as well. What is up next? We got about 10,000 coins, and at one point I will cash in some of my reserve guys for coins as well. Right now I'm finding this sick TJ Ward, 92 overall, for under 5,000. I will definitely take that. That'll leave me with about 5,000 coins left, 5,300. Let's see what we can do with these. First of all, let's take what we've bought and put into the lineup here. Now I know these are not the best cards out there, but again, I'm bargain shopping for the coins that I have. I don't want to pull packs because packs are really kind of a waste unless you're trying to get certain inserts, which, you know, frankly, you probably can do just as well if you have the coins, searching for them on the auction house. I know everybody has a different way of going about it, but the best way for me to build up this team right now and get them close to like a 90 overall here, as you see, I'm now an 88. Is do a little bargain shopping here with these guys who probably were higher when they first came out as fantasy cards or playoff cards, and there are enough of them out there that they're quite on the cheap right now. So going and fixing up my secondary here, let's put up that TJ Ward there in at strong safety. That'll help out right there. Team chemistry still needs some work, but right now I'm worried about the overall more than the chemistry. We do have two chemistry sets now that we are over that magic 85 overall mark. So going back and trying to do some more shopping here. Now you see I was back up to 14,000 coins. It's because I sold off all my silvers that were in reserve. I'm going to grab Alex Boone and then Ronnie Brown, who are both going to help in, I think they both had ground and pound or, you know, whatever. We're going to try to get some similar assets there for chemistry. Although we're still on short pass and run stuff are the two highest. But let's go ahead and put Alex Boone at a 93 overall in there. He was the cheapest one out there that I could find at the time. And then let's put Ronnie Brown in, who is an upgrade over MJD. So we're just about done messing with the lineup. But, you know, I saw one more thing I wanted. If I go sell just enough and get 5,400. I only need is 5,000. I want to get this Barry Cofield 90 overall D tackle, shore up the defensive line. And that is where we're going to call it good enough, because we pretty much run out of coins for the time being. So this episode is done as far as getting the team set, but we want to hit the field one time before we're out of here, because I like to match both the team setup and card collecting with on-field action as well. So we're going to go hit an offline challenge really quickly here. Just a regular season challenge against the Minnesota Vikings. We're sporting the Texans home jerseys here, but playing in Miami. And that's something you only will see in Ultimate Team as you get the mix and match. So here we go. Playing on the Xbox One for the first time, which is kind of fun. I get the chance to use the Kinect controls, the Kinect integration once again. Love that in the Xbox 360. And it seems to be even more refined in the Xbox One version, so it's kind of nice once again to be able to call out, run, pass when you're playing on defense. Try to get that little advantage in your adjustments here without having to mess around on your D-pad forever and all that stuff. I was never really good at that. And my offense gets in for a touchdown the first of the day. Drew Brees is able to hook up with Sharp for the touchdown. Nice job right there. And as you see on the Xbox One, it's set as default to record your game clips of your big highlight plays. Well, mainly touchdowns. So you see right there, that clip will be recorded. I'll have to go check that out and see what I can put together with my recorded game clips in a little bit. But for right now, we've got a lead, and let's see if we can hold on to it. The Vikings are marching down here before halftime, and Christian Ponder, really? He's going to hit Cordero Patterson for a touchdown. Well, if you say so, I guess he crossed the line there in the mind of the referee. So third quarter action, and Ronnie Brown is putting the spin move on and almost broke that one all the way. Nice tackle to stop him there, but Breeze is throwing to Julius Thomas for a big first down to the rookie tight end. Drew Breeze doing all right here. Obviously, these are very short quarters. With the time elapsing quickly, there's a pass to Roddy White, makes the catch, 22 yards, and we are driving. Now we are at the two-minute warning, trying to kill some of this clock and get Ronnie Brown in the end zone. We succeed on both. So Breeze hands off to Ronnie Brown. He does the rest, and we're in the end zone with the go-ahead score once again. Under 2 minutes now. Ponder wants to throw. That's a bad idea. It is picked off by Hayward. Nice little spin move. Gets him around Kyle Rudolph and inside the red zone on the turnover. Ponder ends up on the turf on his back, trying to get to Cordarrelle Patterson once again. Not going to happen right there, so we go right back to our offense after this Snickers replay on the pick. Hayward, look at the spin move. Yeah, nice job. Okay, so we got the ball back, and we are primed to score once again here, or just run out the clock, one or the other. Ronnie Brown gets a block out front and just about gets into the end zone there, but he'll be marked short. We take a knee a couple times, and on third and goal, with all the timeouts exhausted, there is a run for Maurice Jones-Drew checking into the ballgame. He gets a touchdown run, and it's 21-7. Again, we're recording the game clip. Thank you, Xbox One. So here we go with the Vikings. They've actually come down the field. Ponder, nice little throw, and that time there's no doubt. Cordarrelle Patterson definitely crossed the goal line that time. His second score of the day. And he spikes that one with authority, but they've got to get this onside kick if they want a chance. No, sir. Colston covers that up. And we are going to salt this away. 21-14 win for Team Nodis Fan. First Xbox One victory. That's worth a Gatorade shower, isn't it? Sure, why not? Hey, I called for that Gatorade shower via the Kinect controls, which was kind of cool. It showed up there as a choice. So I'm like, yeah, let's do the Gatorade shower. So there you go. We started off Mutt 25 a little late, but we finally got the Xbox One copy. And I'm like, you know what? I'm looking forward to doing this. I wanted to transfer my team. And now I've done just that, so that gives me a reason to actually work on this team. I don't know that I'll really keep up with the collections this late in the game, but I'm just happy to be playing Mutt 25 on the Xbox One, having fun with it. So, what do you guys want to see added to this team with a limited amount of coins? I don't know, if you got some bargains out there you want to pitch to me to help my lineup, by all means, go ahead and leave them in the comment section below, and we will see you next time for more Madden Ultimate Team on the Xbox One. Come on back. We'll see you then.